Simon & Schuster Audio presents Eleadership, proven techniques for creating an environment of speed and flexibility in the digital economy by Susan Annunzio, read by the author.
You've got it all, the great job, all the right perks, the beautiful house, wonderful spouse, fun kids, even the picture-perfect golden retriever. You've made it. You have run your company or your division or group well. You made some hard choices during your career, but now the company is streamlined and profits are strong. Even if you're experiencing some bumps in the road, well, you've made it through tough times before. You are proud of your accomplishments. But these days, more often than not, you wake up and look in the mirror and ask yourself, what's it all about? Is this it? You may have made a difference to the bottom line, but something is still missing. You read every day in the papers about some new dot-com company that is inventing a better way to market and distribute products. How long will it be before one of them finds a way to put your company on the run? How do you transform your company's structure and culture without losing control? And when you have transformed the organization, you wonder, will you still have a place in it? Down deep, you know that if you don't face up to those tough questions, your company may not survive the e-revolution. This program is designed primarily for those of you who lead traditional businesses. My goal is to prove to you that the opportunity of a lifetime may be sitting in front of you, the opportunity to transform your company into a player in the e-revolution while winning the hearts and minds of your workforce. If you are ready to make your difference in the world, if you are ready to meet the challenge of a lifetime, you have a real opportunity right in front of you. We call it e-leadership. This program is designed to do four things. 1. It promises to leave a company poised to do business successfully in the electronic world, using a five-step model that I have developed over 25 years of consulting, but have tailored to the electronic era. 2. The model will help you affect real change at your company by bringing the rhetoric of change to the floor, by eliminating the gap between what is stated publicly and what is implicitly encouraged on a daily basis. 3. E-leadership will help you create an environment that appeals to top talent of both the baby boom and younger X and Y generations, and then to close the gap between the generations so they can work together effectively. 4th, and finally, I hope to inspire you to stay in traditional businesses with the promise that you may end up a hero, saving jobs, resurrecting corporations, and improving lifestyles. Why do I think e-leadership is so vital right now? There has never been a time in history that has witnessed so much change occurring so rapidly and affecting so many people. Business decisions have always been based on economics, the allocation of scarce resources. But the economy of the 21st century is centered on intangible resources, creativity, ideas, thinking. And those are unlimited resources. In the new e-world, the winners will be those companies that create environments to keep the best talent and allow the free expression of ideas. The other factor, in my view, that makes e-leadership so critical is that companies and entire industries are in peril. Many have been lulled by the boom economy of the 90s, but the world around us is changing faster than many of us ever dreamed. We live in a world where the financial models of success have been turned upside down. The only thing we do know is that if we keep the best and smartest people, and we put them in a room together and trust their judgment, we have a better chance than the next guy. So that is the goal of this program, to help you create an environment that will keep the best and smartest people on board. I struggle with the same challenges every day. I am helping my company and my clients reinvent business models. I need to collaborate with Gen X and Y kids to be successful. And that's why I have written this program. I am the baby boomer who wanted to make a difference. I am the leader confronting profound changes in the business world today. In the past 25 years, I have learned a lot through trial and error, through making mistakes, and through not knowing what to do, about how you engage a workforce, how you create an environment where talent thrives, how you can collaborate and spur creativity through a corporation. Now, at a pivotal point in my career, I believe the world really needs the skills I possess. I hope that my experience and ideas can help you and your company deal with the challenges of the 21st century. The men and women featured in this book are just like you. They are leading companies struggling to find their place in the digital economy. But in one way or another, they are all changing their go-to-market strategies and trying to rally the workforce in times of change, to create an environment that will not only survive, but thrive in the high-tech world. This program is designed to help you leave behind your old corporate culture and build the flexible workplace environment you need to recruit and retain the best and the brightest. If you get it right and produce this environment, you will be able to build your business platform, gain a competitive advantage, and possibly be the first to figure out how to make technology really work for you. The E-Leadership Challenge. What if one morning you arrived at your corporate offices and no one was there? Your marketing staffers had decided to base themselves at various client headquarters. The salespeople, equipped with Palm Pilots, ThinkPads, and digital wireless phones, were operating in mobile virtual offices. Your support staff, accounting, communications, corporate counsel, preferred to telecommute, plugging into network from home offices and talking to each other via email and fax. What if, sitting alone at a big desk, you realized you didn't need a corporate office building at all? What would you do? Welcome to the world of e-leadership, where business strategies are fluid, workers are smarter and more demanding than ever, and the old rules of business just don't apply anymore. It's a world of global markets, ad hoc teams, telecommuters, email, video conferences, online ordering, virtual offices, intranets, networked alliances, and instant information. And it's full of both challenges and opportunities for e-leaders. So what is e-leadership? E-leadership is a new style of business management designed specifically to guide top executives as they retool their businesses to compete in the new e-world. E-leadership means shaking up your corporate culture and fostering an attitude of speed and flexibility in order to facilitate the internal transformation to an environment for the digital economy. E-leadership means managing the clash between baby boomers and the new brash Generation X and Y workers, and finding a way to combine the talents of both groups to achieve success. E-leadership means making the tough decisions that will set your company on the path to success in the digital economy, and in the process save jobs, companies, and even entire industries. E-leadership demands heroic behavior. It entails breaking many of the rules we've played by for generations. It means sacrificing the comfort of the status quo in the quest for a new direction that will survive the e-revolution. And most important, e-leadership ultimately is not about connecting technology, but about connecting people. Dave Tolmie, CEO of YesMail.com, a permission email marketer, says, "The success of the new economy company is based on the collective capabilities of its people. Every company needs to be more collegial and less structured so that the collective talents have a way to manifest themselves. Microsoft Chairman Bill Gates echoed the significance of the work environment in his book, Business at the Speed of Thought. The most important speed issue is often not technical but cultural. It's convincing everyone that the company's survival depends on everyone moving as fast as possible. Reinforcing that comment.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.